Welcome to the Black & Veatch World Headquarters and our Innovation Pavilion. Our Innovation Pavilion is powered by a microgrid composed of both traditional and renewable energy generation sources. As a true microgrid, we have the ability to island or operate independently from the utility grid. Join us now for a tour of our microgrid.
Asset 360 is Black & Veatch's smart analytics platform that captures, integrates, and analyzes data of our microgrid to generate actionable information that can boost operational performance and sharpen planning insights. We are able to analyze our specific assets, such as the microturbines, the PV solar arrays, and the battery energy storage system, to enable more informed decisions and actions. The dashboard and scorecard conveys the results of the operation of the microgrid and allows for clear-cut operation and planning understanding. This helps us to accelerate the convergence of physical infrastructure, communications, and data analytics to provide system-wide synergies and value.
The central nervous system of our microgrid consists of an off-the-shelf programmable logic control system. This PLC coordinates communication and controls between our individual microgrid resources, as well as providing data to our servers for more detailed analytics. Black & Veatch has developed custom control routines to operate our microgrid, including solar capacity firming, peak demand shaving, and islanding modes. Additionally, the PLC supports functionality for future integration of third-party software and also provides Black & Veatch with a platform to continue to develop and refine future applications to adapt our system as market conditions expand and evolve.
Each of these microturbines are capable of producing about 65 kilowatts each. Natural gas comes in off the main utility line and is fed into this compressor right here. Natural gas is compressed from about 10 psi to 80 psi. The compressed gas is then ready for combustion and is fed into the turbine. We use the hot exhaust gas coming off to feed through a heat recovery loop that then goes into the building.
Thermal energy from the microturbine's exhaust gases is recovered to maximize energy usage. A mixture of water and propylene glycol is pumped through the microturbine where the exhaust gas deposits thermal energy into the fluid. The mixture is then pumped to the building where it passes through copper braised stainless steel heat exchangers. Water is then heated without heavy usage of the electric boiler, saving money and electricity. The heated water is then transferred to the HVAC system throughout the building. In the summer months, the thermal energy from the microturbines is exhausted through a dry cooling unit. Also installed is a geothermal system. It optimizes the temperature of the earth to provide additional heating and cooling support of the HVAC system in the world headquarters.
The energy from the generating assets of the microgrid is stored in the battery energy storage system, in short, BESS. The BESS is a 100 kilowatt, 100 kilowatt-hour battery pack system, which means it can provide 100 kilowatts of power for an hour. The main components of the BESS are the battery packs themselves, the PCS, or the power conversion system, which converts the AC to DC and the DC to AC. The third component in the battery energy storage system is the battery management system, which takes care of the health of the batteries, the state of charge, and monitors all the controls of the batteries. The final component and the most important component to the BESS is the BESS site controller, which houses all the advanced algorithms for operating the BESS in multiple modes. The BESS is capable of operating in conjunction with the PV solar when the PV solar generation is not quite adequate, so it could compensate for the solar, and it could also smoothen solar output, called PV ramp rate control, energy time shift operations, peak load shaving for the building so we can cut down the electricity cost of the building overall, and also for ancillary services like voltage regulation and frequency control.
This is the body of the microgrid switchgear 3A. All the microgrid power sources come into the switchgear where the energy will be delivered to the Innovation Pavilion or fed back to the existing building depending on our building needs. In the switchgear we have two significant circuit breakers that isolate it into two key parts. One, the main circuit breaker that bridges the microgrid power sources to the existing utility grid. And second, the tie circuit breaker that isolates the microgrid power sources to the Innovation Pavilion load. This is the microturbine contactor panel. It has contacts that isolate from the existing utility grid. The reason for doing this is that the microturbines need to ramp up its system voltage and have the correct phase angle. This is switchgear 3 and this is switchgear 4. Above and beyond just what we did with the microgrid, we also wanted to have a better understanding of our building needs. So we purchased additional CTs for each of these existing switchgear, and through doing so, we have a better understanding of our overall system.
There are 25 kilowatt solar systems on both the east and west building roofs, all ballasted racking. There are a combination of technologies, monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and central inverters, and AC modules with string inverters. The 1,000-volt DC string inverter is on the west building. The east building uses a combination of 600-volt DC single-phase string inverters and microinverters. We choose to include different panel and inverter types to better understand the pros and cons of each system when it comes to levelized cost of energy. A weather monitoring system was also installed to gather data on how different levels of cloud cover will affect the system and each module technology type.
As part of our mission to offer educational opportunities for our clients and our community, we offer private and group tours of the microgrid. Please contact your sales representative or bv.com to arrange for a tour.